brain. Well, just working on other things, and all of a sudden, oh, where'd the time go? It's like, oh, I still have a minute, and all of a sudden, oh, where'd the time go? I don't have any more time. And here we are once again. Thanks for joining us. Without further ado, Midday in the Middle. This is Art4Truth. We are Art4Truth. What we like to call Electric Tuesdays. So I'll play some electric music. Sometimes I get a little heavy. Sometimes I really get crunchy with the electricity. Sometimes I do stuff that's a little out there. Most of what I do is electric anyways. Sometimes I just go off and rant for a while about electricity and what it might mean in various interpretations, definitions, and gravities. Electric guitar, what a profound invention that turned out to be for us. Most of humanity. That was different. See, when you're dealing with something like electricity, you have frequency disruptions that are capable of happening, so there we go. If it was straight up acoustic, that wouldn't have happened. Unless I went kick, which can happen, I guess. The give and the take, but it is an incredible phenomenon that hit the world. 40s, 50s, 60s. It wasn't overnight. Definitely, of course, the 60s is the explosion of a lot of things. Electric guitar is an incredible instrument. It's funny because a lot of our searchings into ourselves and our primordial connections and all these other things and a lot of stuff that people did in the 60s to try to connect to that. Just as an example, and one of the reasons that the electric guitar was such a profound instrument and tool in people's discoveries and voyages back then and why it still is today. There's an almost ironic connection to that sort of side of our existence, and then a man-made invention like electricity. It's not a man-made invention, not at all. We use it. We have incorporated and manipulated it, of course, but no, it happens in the sky. It happens in the ocean. Electricity is a very real thing. A natural phenomenon, if you will, and so incorporating that as best we can into our greater understanding of sort of our art of music, our connection to it individually and collectively, I think has been one of the great discoveries, one of the great uses of electricity in our time. Many, many not so great ones. We won't get into that. Not right this second anyways. Thank you. just switching around, playing around with electricity a little bit, the electric guitar, the electricity of my own thoughts, perhaps. It can be nice and bright, it can be a little bit foreboding, so many things, like all music can be. But it also can be something else, something like interdimensional sounds. Electricity can help us find in music something that we have yet found, have not found exactly in acoustics. So there's a closeness. You can get rattly, spacey vibrations from mixing certain things, there's no doubt. Different shells or different types of sheets, paper mill, whatever, all kinds of different things. And bones, oh my goodness, it goes on. From the very basic brunt, sand. The basics of our life, our physical experience, we can reach the deep outwardness, the deep infinites of space. One of the things that electricity has done is sort of went boom, like a skylight. Just like we literally got hit by lightning in a lot of ways when we figured the way that music and art affects our consciousness. When we start to jump to like being able to make all of these incredible we can do stuff like that with just our fingertips and that little movement of our feet. A pretty incredible phenomenon that can really supercharge us into new forms of reality, of existence, of understanding, of connecting. Center of a supernova and be able to record all of the symphony, all of the microcosms, every note that's being performed, every note that's being played, the music. What was the music of the Big Bang? What are the musics of small bangs? What about the music of quote-unquote dark matter? notes and scales are something perhaps even a bit deeper, something that's the foundation of our chords and scales, something that holds ours together, the vibrations of it, the individual compositions, the unseen energies that hold the things together to make something out of nothing. A lot that we can find and do with a little bit of electricity or two. Exploring, especially through music, through art, through the imagination, because a lot of things that most people don't realize are true are going to be exposed to be true not too distant future. And there's always something new, even for the most sage and wise. There's life beyond every single pair of eyes. Put all of them together, however, and you get a pretty good sense of what might be happening in the universe. We can continue to do that. There is not a reason I can see that we cannot continue to harness and maybe have some change. Powers of electricity to continue to connect to create a sense of creativity, harmony, connection to the source of reality. In our individual ways, connected somehow through larger efforts to incorporate a collective human soul into a beautiful vision of consciousness that each person can be a part of. We do have so much potential, and we're beautiful in and of ourselves, so let us continue to grow and to evolve. While we can do different, a lot we can learn from, a lot we can learn from that we haven't learned from yet. So yes, I will say that we have an electricity as people, as a conscious organism, that I think that we can do a lot better in understanding and incorporating into life than we do. So anyways, there we go. This is a pretty nice electric effect. Let's try this for a second. Thank you. All right, well, that does bring us to the end of our Midday in the Middle jam, Electric Tuesday. This was a fun little jam. Hope you enjoyed it. Thank you all very much for your ear and your time. I hope you continue to have a wonderful day and a great week. We'll see you tomorrow with Wacky Wednesday. All right, until then, keep making art, keep loving your heart, and stay blessed.